Guys, I just realized something. It's a 5x5 grid. That's pretty fucking crazy. They really want you. Sorry, they really want you to just rock like a shit ton of weapons with that. I swear. Okay, I just realized something. My unhealing build isn't the best anymore. The infinite heat generation build is no longer the best unhealing build in the game. I am sorry to say. The reason I'm saying that is because of this item. You heal 50% of your maximum health. Now, the best way of increasing your maximum health on your Reaper is utilizing the hearts. Right? Because you... Yeah. You gain 90 maximum health when you use 7 regeneration. The best way to get this regeneration is the potions. These guys. And you rock this with Cauldron. So the best unhealing build in a game, realistically, is Cauldron, strong health potions, unhealing, utilizing that item. And you get your maximum health because your strong health potions will proc at 50% health, giving you more maximum health. And then when FAT kicks in, boo! All that maximum health is dealt as damage. Now, alternatively, what you can do is instead of utilizing heart containers, you can run these. Wait, no. I thought this increased your maximum for some reason. These don't increase your maximum, do they? Never mind, I take that back then. So yeah. Yeah. Boom. Right? They don't increase maximum health, right? Yeah. They just consume this and 35% life steal. Yeah. Okay. Never mind. I wonder. Maximum health. I mean, then again, this also increases your maximum health by 55. Which is... But like, who's gonna run snake unhealing? Like, no one's gonna run the snake with an unhealing build. Like, that's just not smart.
Oh my god.
That's not possible, right? Infinite empowerment unhealing build with this guy? That's like a bomb. That's a fucking bomb, bro. That is a fatigue bomb. You just build up all your maximum health utilizing the thorn bloom. That just sounds like a bomb. And then when a fatigue kicks in, boom! Deal like fucking 600 damage. Insta-killing the person, bro. That just, like, oh my gosh. Oh, this increases your max health. Interesting. I wonder if this is better. I wonder if this is better than heart containers. It would be cheaper. It would definitely be cheaper than heart containers, but it's only 25. The heart container is 90. Like, let's say you have two of those, it's 180 max health. You wouldn't need like a lot of these. Not to mention max health isn't damage. So the regular health potions, when they heal, that's actual, like, damage as well, so, yeah. Yeah. And then I also was thinking, like, Nocturnal Locklifter. Your healing is amplified by 25%. So instead of that being, like, 50%, it'll be 25% of 50%. So it just increases it, your healing. that you'll do, which also increases the damage that you'll do, right? Either way, I feel like Cauldron and Nocturnal Locklifter would be the better unhealing builds instead of it being just Mr. Struggles. Because it's hard to get Mr. Struggles up and going. Because you need to fish for the giraffes and everything, right? You also need to have the heat generator, deck of cards, etc. it's a nice build, but it's hard to get going. Versus like Nocturnal Locklifter, you just buy this and you're good. Cauldron, you just buy this and you're good. It's not like you gotta go fish for items or anything. Pretty convenient. You're like Nocturnal Locklifter with like Vampiric, or with Hungry Blade. That'll probably be better. Or even like Prismatic Sword would be pretty good. Prismatic Sword would be really good. It's just inconsistent thing to get. But I mean, I guess you can rock Hungry Blade plus Nocturnal Locklifter and stuff. And I guess like if you're at round 7 and you don't already have that many health potions or something, then just go Nocturnal Locklifter, I think. Hey Valdis, what's up? I'll try that real quick. So we're here, right? So my priority will just be health potions and regeneration, right? That would probably be my priority. And then trying to get the unhealing staff. So here I want like a broom, right? Well, to be honest, getting a shine shell wouldn't be horrible. I can also just sell these items down here. It's not the end of the world. All right, got my broom. I got my regeneration. Now this is what? That's 4 gold I can sell, which I probably need to. I'll just both of these get this combination there. Get that next round. Probably get the stone as well. Bag of stones plus totem is good. Doing good. Having problems with lag. Got internet issues. Oh, we lost. Damn. It's fine though. Let's get all those, get a combo that could just be there. Just pretty much just rock this, try to get a Hungry Blade ASAP. First one we see, we buy. That 5 blind blows, we're fine. Nice. Round 3, that's all it took. That's it. Wow. All right, I'll take you. I could low-key rock all 3 of 1.9, but I use this reduction in stamina, but it's not like I want to keep this forever, right? I think this is just better to just have here versus the ladder. So we're just gonna rock these two, and I don't feel like rolling. I'll just roll next round and just rock this. Drives me insane to have good upload and download, but the lag sucks. That's weird. It's weird to have good upload and download, but you still lag. Nice. Oh my gosh, we got investment opportunity. Holy shit. Holy shit. Holy shit. That's a W. Massive W right there. Massive W. Ooh, massive W. I say we just buy these amulets. Honestly, we're kind of like, I don't know, we're kind of in the lead. Getting this early, kind of in the lead. I'll take my chances here. Refund buffs, not bad. Not bad at all. No bag of stones, no stones. We could still try to fish for them though. I mean, wouldn't hurt. Should I get this banana? I'll get a bean ant. Don't mind. Rock something like this. I could also do this with a bloody goober. I'm not sure if I want to, though. Not sure if I want to. We need to find more regeneration. I'd like the regeneration to be at the beginning of the game and not, like, towards the end. You know? That'd be a little bit better, I think. Oh, there goes my magic staff that I need. Be taking both of those. Which means, more than likely, we don't need Shell Totem anymore. We don't even have Bag of Souls to even utilize this empowerment, realistically, right? Well, we do this round, right? But like, I'd rather just have Magic Staff into Hungry Blade versus just, you know, that, right? So we're just gonna rock that. I'll go ahead and separate these two just to get a little bit more use out of the, yeah, out of that. That's fine. All right, and then we'll just roll. Pretty damn nice. Take the healing herb. I think I'm gonna take this wooden sword too, because, you know, maybe we'll get a prismatic sword. I'm not even gonna cap. Like, getting a prismatic sword wouldn't be bad. I haven't put my OBS output to, and it lowers my graphics on the video game, and it still lags. Something's gotta be up. That's weird. Yeah, something's amiss. Something's afoot. Oh, damn, we lost. Woo. Surprisingly. Good game, though. Blood amulet. It's pretty interesting. Not sure if I want it. I'm not getting vampiric potions. It could be good for the Goobert, though. Yeah. But do I want it now? Am I even going to get the Goobert? I don't know. Round 6. Don't know. I don't think so. Toad can be okay. Just for mana generation, realistically. Because we kind of do need some mana generation. So I'll go ahead and get it. Call that a day. We're lacking on the health potions, though. Only got one. Kind of sucks. Oh, that maximum health is looking nice. Looking nice. Very nice. Ooh. Investment of opportunity. With fencing rapier is very interesting. I think I want to try it. It's on sale. It's worth a shot to, like, at least try it out. I'll replace that guy, I think. Probably gonna get the amulet here. Really nothing else I want to buy. Definitely don't need that. Definitely do not need that. See what happens here, though. This guy's got Tuscan Poker, and that's it. Sheesh. All right, since we only have one, you know, strong health potion, I think we just go Nocturne, Lock Builder here. We got one. Is it the best in the world? I'd much prefer to have more than one. I don't think I go Toad. Maybe Toad's better on there. But yeah, I don't think I go Toad. I think I just stick with this. Because this should just be enough mana generation realistically for us. Yeah, just rock with this. Another amulet. I shall buy you as soon as I can, eventually. All right, now we just need vampiric items, the unhealing staff, shit ton of hungry blades, stuff like that. That maximum health was so nice. I guess we'll pick up these blood amulets now, because we're going to need them for the Nocturnal Locklifter, right? That would be smart. Amulet of Alchemy, I guess we'll keep you. Honestly, since we're going Nocturnal Locklifter, I might as well turn these into vampiric potions. Yeah, I might as well turn them into vampiric potions, I think. There we go. That'll work, but yeah. And that'll give me another vampiric item to use on the Nocturnal Locklifter, which will be beneficial for us. Nice. We had 100 more health than they did. Disgusting. Good morning, King Kong. This is interesting. We could use Mana Mastery here. And that would just be our mana generation that we'll need. Stone is useless. And Spacious wouldn't be bad. Spacious wouldn't be a bad choice, realistically. But I think we just go with Mana Mastery because, mana generation. So yeah, we're gonna go with that. We're gonna go with that. I wonder how, like, should I just keep buying mana ores with Mana Mastery or no? It's an interesting question. I don't know the answer to that. Really don't. I don't even know if I should keep using Fancy 50 Rapier or should I switch back to the Hungry Blade. Maybe we switch back to the... No, I don't know. I don't know. I truthfully do not know. Which one would be better? That should be enough mana generation, though. Should probably put this here, just in case. I mean, it might proc. Maybe. Possibly. That's looking decent, though. It might proc. It's not like our mana generation is lacking or anything like that. So I might as well give me another mana orb. Why not? Sure. I'll get another one. Next round. Damn, he went shielded and mana mastery. He's not using either of them for anything. Well, I guess mana mastery for your friendly king. There's that, I suppose. But other than that, he's not using it for jack shit. Nada. Round 11. Oh yeah, I went mana. I was like, where's my other? Yeah. Okay. I guess we'll go health potion here. So we can get another vampiric potion for that. And prismatic orb would not be bad at all. We can use that for starting mana to get the mana orbs to proc. So these three would not be bad. I say we buy that though, because we need this for the combination. And then I guess we'll, I don't know where to put this mana orb. I guess here. As long as it's on a weapon, I feel like it's the most important thing right now. It being on a weapon. It's probably a better way for me to min-max this, like, potion situation, but I'm not gonna worry about it too hard. That's not a bad spot. Well, I'm not getting the extra star slot, but at least it's both in those. I doubt it'll proc, though, realistically. Maybe that's okay. Man, there's so much you have to worry about when it comes to, like, spacing. With these new items. You told your mom to call Xfinity to see if they can fix it? Gotcha. Fingers crossed they can. Still looking for an unhealing staff. Kind of need that. Ooh. Tough. Sure. No unhealing staff. Sucks. What's the best location for this? Genuinely unsure. 2, 4, 6, 8. I mean, 8 mana at the start of the game isn't bad. I guess I'll go with this. First build, yuck. With the acorn ace, yuck. We win! I blame the potions, honestly. Potions helped so much. Winning that, for real. Not a bad shop. What if I get a mana thirst? Or, like, not a mana thirst, but the... That wouldn't be bad, actually. Yeah, let's get a mana thirst. Because that's another magic item. We already got 2 mana orbs. Like, that actually would be a pretty good idea. We might even be able to rock all 3 because it's going to use up less stamina anyway, so... Yeah. Which comes to shove, we can also just get a rabbit since we're getting so many buffs. Ooh. What a freaking battle. Oh my gosh. That went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. That was crazy. Oh, this is actually really good with the Phoenix because it uses up all that heat. And then when it uses buff, you gain even more maximum health. Wow. Investment opportunity is really good with Phoenix. Probably with Dark Lantern. Well, no, Dark Lantern doesn't give you health. It doesn't use up buffs. So yeah, investment opportunity is really good with this. It's a good placement too. Flame Whip, Friendly Fiend, 570 maximum health. And then he got powered and Mooney's getting a moon armor. Bro. Investment opportunity with freaking powered moon. Bro. Crazy combination. Ooh, we're about to cook. Indeed. Indubitably. 1.5 is not bad. Yeah. 1.5 is not bad at all. At all. Probably should rearrange, though, which means... Well, I could go for a Prismatic Sword. Like, I could go for a Prismatic Sword and get rid of Fancy Fin's Reader. Like, I have that opportunity right now. With the unhealing staff? Yes, we do that, we do that. We might lose this. 2.2 is pretty damn high. We might lose, but... It'll be okay. Hopefully. Possibly not. We're only gonna need one more star. I feel like we're... Yeah, we're fine. Well... Yeah, we'll be fine. We don't need this. Yeah, give me something good. Bro, I said something good. I don't need this bullshit. I'm gonna get this glowing crown because it's free. Probably losing. This is a very weird build. What the heck am I looking at? I'm gonna lose though. No stamina. L. Ooh, and we got a bunny. Okay, so we don't need you anymore. We're gonna put you right in the middle. You're gonna go over here because you're also a vampiric item, which means we put you over here, and that's all the vamp items I need. You think I should have dropped a rapier like 100%? Possibly. Might have been a best play. Should probably put everything in my relic case too. Be like that. Wait, what happened to my other vamp? Oh. Get out of my face. All right, now we just gotta figure out a better min-max for this. Oh, Nocturnal Oculus doesn't affect the Staff of Unhealing. So you don't even have to be over here, which means I could put mana orbs between these. And that's just better. Like this. Interesting. Hey, Smojo, you saw meta already? Yep. This is just right here. Hey, Crystallize. Now I gotta figure out where this guy is gonna go. That's not bad. These are all the items that even use up buffs anyways. Yeah. That's a good spot. Where are you gonna go? Here? Well... guess? Guess there. Still need to have 27 gold. I've been buying space this entire time. 27 gold? What's wrong with me? Put the blue gem above? Which, you talking about mana? You talking about this or this? You mean like move it up here or something? Frog on amulet is good. What amulet? You talking about mana mastery, I assume? I mean, he just gained 3 buffs. That's gonna heal. If I were to move this down. Like, moving it down wouldn't be horrible, actually. And then doing that. Yeah, this stays like this. Blue amulet above mana thirst for both orbs and stat. So like this, basically. But what about the prismatic sword? I mean, we're losing the prismatic sword, but we're gaining a mana, like, because it would be 1, 2, 3, 4. But we put it up here, it's still 4. I mean, it's still 4. Speed up the prismatic sword with magic items.
As much as you can. As much as you possibly can. Dun dun dun!
Dun dun dun! Alright, there we go. 6, 2, and 1. This looks insane. I'm not gonna cap. This is absurd. Oh, frog triggering off of yellow amulet is pretty crazy. Oh, that's what you... So you think I should just, like, do that, basically. Okay. Stamina is an issue. I mean, we're at 1.8. We have bunny. Maybe not. And I have starting mana? Yeah. Maybe that's okay though, because we definitely generate more than enough mana. We definitely generate more than enough mana that we need. More than enough. I'm trying to get these mana orbs of proc. But maybe the person will just die. I want to see these mana orbs proc, and I want to see this mana mastery put in some fucking work. That's my goal. Oh, with the starting mana. Yeah. So we need a prismatic orb, basically. Yellow amulet gains loads of buffs for frog. Mana orbs is trash. The only reason I'm buying them is for this mana mastery. That's the only reason. I just want to see the mana mastery work. That's it. Just to use the new item. Use the new item and see the new item be happy. Because it gets the items it needs to work. That's all. So I'm about to make this motherfucker fast as fucking possible. This guy will survive, right? Uh-oh, we're out of stamina. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, big uh-oh. Oh, we're fine. And I just realized this thing is not inside of the case. Use up less stamina. I don't need you, right? Nope. I think he means yellow amulet in frog star. Oh, that's what you mean. So put the yellow amulet inside of the frog star since it refunds the buffs, it gives the buffs and will trigger the frog effect. Gotcha. I was so confused, Bull Squid. My bad, bro. Yeah, I can make that happen. There we go. Now it's like even better. My apologies. He probably was like, this motherfucker. Yeah, we need stamina and prismatic orb. Another bunny! Is it good? As soon as we can. Yeah, because we definitely need so much stamina. Oh no. No! Damn it. Give me stamina. Now. Should I buy this? I don't know. I don't want to. The game knows exactly what I want. Alright, that's my last one. That's my last one, I promise. I promise. That's the last one. We're not buying any more after that. No more. No more. No more. We're not buying any more. I can hear you yelling at me. I can hear it. I can feel you breathing. Stop.
It's too much.
Uh-oh.
Oh no!
Jesus Christ. Well, he died. None of my mana orbs progged. We're at 29. Damn. This makes me feel like mana mastery just is not good. That's what it makes me feel like right now. I mean, it did generate 9 mana, but like... Eh. Yeah, Prismatic Sword was super strong. It's just good. It's just good. I really wanted to see the freaking Mana Mastery put in some work, though. It just died quick. All 2-stage skills for Reaper are bad apart from debuff slash vamp in case of struggles.